Okay, Jan Berin, please.
So, do you hear me?
Yes, no.
Merci aux organisateurs. The past 2 years, in northern half of France, a team of INRAP researchers is carrying out an inventory of textile furniture from a topological or chronological perspective. My personal work is complementary. Its purpose is to help understand the contextual data related to textile craftsmanship. My interest in spindle world and loom weights led me to work on the theme of the representation of this craft in the proto-historic society. That is, how to testify to your belonging to textile universe by wearing a specific set, or how this universe is described in the graphic image of proto-history. My aim today is to convince you that there is a close link between the feminine pendant and textile production. I will illustrate this hypothesis with 2 examples. So, the first concerns a range of ornaments that can be described as looms. The most obvious models come from Italy and serve as a starting point for this work. In this case, this is the case of Cannavaccio di Urbino, which seems to indicate the desire to represent textile craftsmen on clothes. On this slide, the same color code is used to describe the loom, with blue for the warp beam bar on the second bar, the green for the woven work, the orange for weights. At the bottom, the same color code is adapted to the object and terminology of parts constituting them, the hook, the intermediate pieces, the chains or other connecting system, a possible additional bar on the pendants. By analogy with Italian furniture, the same hypothesis can be made for similar sets of furniture. We have chosen to consider all those with pendants. These pendants are identified in various categories of objects, which are themselves separated into topological classes. There is a parallel between the disc-shaped weight of Central Europe and of Mediterranean. Similarly, the Hallstattian pyramidal weights, which find their equivalents in contemporary ornaments. One is represented flat and made of metal, the other being made in volume and in clay. The hypothesis I propose is that the articulated bales of the continental final Bronze Age match the same kind of representation. In France, the typology of loom weights is favorable to the same hypothesis in the case of bales. Cylindrical weights are replaced by piriform weights with soft edges, then pyramidal and more angular, and finally triangular shapes could trace an evolution of object or associated techniques. The general design of the bales can evoke the weaver's work through the weaving of the metal elements. The end decoration can represent an evocation of a narrow loom that can be used to make borders decorated on either side of a wide loom. Many belts have this element at both ends, which could refer to the weaving of the strips. In my opinion, it is an additional argument in favor of this interpretation in relation to weaving. Other older forms are identified with the arciform ornaments of the beginning of the final Bronze Age. The same type of hypothesis can be considered to interpret the French and German examples, so-called arciform ornaments from La Colombine, La Solsotte, or Karlsruhe. These objects incorporate in their design an idea comparable to that of the fibulas or belts mentioned before. Due to their dating, these objects could constitute older forms of weavers' craft pendants. The small group of bronzes considered here at first sight a group of heterogeneous artifacts, but it is surprising to recognize many common characters. These are metal parts, the particularity of which is to be used to connect several parts of a complex set. We can assume a common origin of these different parts from the same matrix, whose general aspect is characterized by an open work treatment, sometimes complex or sometimes closed and reduced to a simple geometrically shaped plate. This rigid support have a simple binding function in the assembly of complex sets. The general design is summarized here in the form of a diagram. The some typical composition sometimes incorporates in its shape the motif of a solar boat, a sun bulb, or a simple geometric shape that is more difficult to interpret, whether or not loaded by an ideology. It is this piece that supports the loom like a warm beam bar. At the base of the object, a larger number of rings are distributed over the entire white. In this lower part, there are sometimes other arrangements, such as simple voids or openings used at a point of attachment to a series of chains. Rods or braiding of metal wires, which symbolically reproduce the woven structure stretched by the weights. The second example of an ornament concerns pins. I hypothesize the existence of a link between the spindle whorls and some pins in the middle and final Bronze Age. The hypothesis would be that we are trying to represent in the finery this tool used for spinning. The conical shape of the head suggests a similar shape between these two categories of tools. The presence on the pins of a belly that can imitate the bobbins or thread on the spindle. On other pins, such as the Picardy pin, it is possible to recognize a pattern comparable to those woven. The hypothesis is to recognize the representation of the work product and therefore a symbolic association between the pin and the spindle. It should be noted that other forms do not seem to work in this interpretation. Here is an example of vasiform head, it means like a vessel. This had led to an interest in other forms of pins, first with a form of disappointment in the half-tone results, but not so long. This is a lively debate among Italian researchers about spindle whorls on vessels. Giovanni Leonardi, Fusaioli in forma di vaso. It shows strong formal links between spindle whorls in red and vessels in blue. Quickly, comparable profiles can be highlighted with an example one, a position of digital decor, or in example four, the figuration of horns. In example two, above right, another high profile with a narrow opening and regular decorated band. A dish decorated in example three. Other details such as presence of a foot in six. A very simple question naturally emerged. Is this hypothesis valid for the collection of the Bronze Age in northern France? The complete copies found in excavation are often in little worn, but comparison is possible. Some characteristics can be observed, such as the presence of digitized decoration on the shoulder or in median part. The profile of the conical spindle whorl Their decoration on the slightly recessed edge seems to us very similar to the clothes with digitized decoration. This set can be compared to Horn's well present in a final regional bronze. The specimen of spindlewort shown here on the right is dug as if they want to represent the inside of the vessel. This is not weird or untier, that may correspond to its use. So I pass other distinctive sign. In the end, this first test on the regional collection seems relevant to us and seems to cover a good part of the categories of non-vessel, bowl or pots. On the left, a slightly provocative image for those interested in object technology. This is an example of from the beginning of the Latin in Picardy. In my opinion, the perfect image of a situla. On the right, what is the link between the three objects? In my opinion, it is necessary to study each type of pin to verify contemporaneity between these objects. Is it just the same fashion at the moment? It could be explained with the way of considering materials at a particular time in the same area. More surely, it's the sign of an underlying concept. For example, these two proposals concerning ornaments may be merged into one. The vessels can symbolically provide a life thread. In this example of Vaudrevanche and Niederjutz presented here, like they were discovered in the beginning of 20th century, the tubes could constitute a form of amalgam between the threads and the weights in the basal part. The methods of representation of the same ID can be very different from one region to another. So to conclude, is Sopron a kind of summary of this ID? There are more to study about vessel which represents loom. We find many in Ostalstadt culture and some abstract version in the west of Europe. I have no time to discuss this specific topic here. So, few points that I want to bring to the community of specialists in textile studies. For European region under consideration, this phenomenon is, in my opinion, a massive phenomenon. These observations do not mean that each region has a similar history or custom and habits. However, their similarity may reflect a common origin or aspiration. It may be a current of thought or trend, but these points are difficult to verify. In some specific cases, they reflect really contact that show that the elites meet from region to region. They reveal also that certain regions are influential through the diffusion of the form they generate. These sets are the expression of a relative plurality of form within this religious framework, which offers a common matrix. It is also a form of mimicry that reminds us of the cousinhood of prestigious objects in Europe and beyond. Almost in a female version, this object evokes such as Charlotte's sword and cauldron that is often mentioned. something like a must-have. Thanks for listening.